It's super potent, it's super expensive, and police say super pot is becoming a big issue in Chicago and the suburbs. Good evening, everyone. I'm Lauren Cohn.
I'm David Navarro. Tara Williams is here with the move to deal with this growing problem. The story new on the 10.
David and Lauren, police tell me super pot, also known as Kush, has not overwhelmed the city and the suburbs like crack cocaine did about 10 years ago, but they say they have seen a spike in the sale of it, and we're talking about big money. Now, if this 2-pound box of sugar was super pot, it would go for about 12 grand.
You're looking at hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of Kush, a highly potent form of pot, also known as Bubba, Paris, or bubblegum on the streets.
The profit potential for Kush is enormous.
1 ounce of Kush sells anywhere from $300 to $700, almost as much as crack cocaine.
Was seized in a bedroom community near Waukegan.
There were 167 pounds total. Police in Chicago, the suburbs, and nationwide say they've seen a spike in the sale of Kush because it's easier to grow, profitable, and popular because it induces a zombie-like state.
We ought to increase the penalties because we don't want to raise a new generation of zombie-like kids who can't perform in school and can't perform athletically.
Backed by suburban police, Congressman Mark Kirk says if you sell Kush for the same price as cocaine, you should face the same penalties.
I had not planned to introduce legislation regarding marijuana, but in conversations with my law enforcement, we are now seeing that this is not your father's marijuana here.
Kirk's bill doesn't go after possession, but it does increase the maximum fines to $1 million for a person or $5 million for a group, with a maximum sentence of 25 years.
Now, I talked to a few Chicago police officers tonight and asked them how they can tell Kush from regular pot when they're out on bus. They say it's sticky to the touch, it has a purple tint to it, and they say they know when they've found it because it can smell up an entire building. Tara Williams, Fox Chicago News.